Jesus is not just a spiritual. Jesus understands our human need also. Jesus used to give eye to people to see spiritual vision, like St. Paul gets the eye to see the Christ in real, the kingdom of heaven. But Jesus has given eyes to those people who are blind physically. They have nothing to do with it spiritually. So Jesus understands our worldly ways. Jesus understands our human emotions also. Jesus understands our day-to-day life also. But there is one occasion where we find Jesus very strict. Jesus, a person who all the time is speaking Father, 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 and physical Father of Jesus, has also great respect in this community. But there was a person whose father was dead, and he comes to Jesus and he wants to follow Jesus, and he says that he wants to go back to bury his father and then come back to Jesus Christ. But Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead, but you go and proclaim the kingdom of heaven." Here we find Jesus Christ extremely strict. Even ordinary person, that person who must be grieved by the death of his father, but Jesus is saying, "Let the dead bury their own dead." What does Jesus mean here? Is Jesus wants to draw our attention to something? We can understand it by one occasion when Jesus fed 5,000 people with just 5 loaves of barley bread, and they were amazed to meet Jesus Christ. Then Jesus answered to them, "I am telling you the truth. You are looking for me because you ate the bread and had all you wanted, not because you understood my miracles. Do not work for the food that goes bad." Even the food that Jesus Christ himself is giving to them, like Jesus fed them with the bread. Can you imagine what joy we will get, that we get that bread that Jesus multiplied from 5 loaves of barley bread to feed 5,000 people as much as they wanted? So even about that bread, Jesus is saying, "Do not work for food that goes bad. Instead, work for the food that lasts for eternal life." By this we can understand that in the context of this person whose father is dead, Jesus is drawing our attention to something that never dies, that is in us all, that is the spirit. Because one more occasion I want to draw our attention, when people were telling about Jesus Christ, they were asking Jesus a question about somebody's whose husband is dies, and she gets married to husband's brother, and even that brother dies, and then she gets married to that brother's brother, and then she also dies, and then all of them come back to life. Then who will be her real husband? And Jesus says that a person who rises to life in this way, in the world of his spirit, through the spirit, they will be like the angels in heaven and will not marry. Means when we really get awakened into the spirit, then there is no difference between people, and we don't get attraction to marry or physical thing, all the temptation or even sexual attraction, any kind that falls down from us, because these are the traits of physical body. But that's not the something that where I want to draw my attention. That's a different topic. What Jesus said after that is very important for us to understand what Jesus wants to teach us all the time. Jesus says, "Now as far as the dead rising to life is concerned," then Jesus is saying, "Haven't you ever read what God has told you?" And he said, "I'm the God," means here it is said what God has told in the scripture, and Jesus is quoting from the scripture that about God. He means God here. "I am the God of Abraham, I'm the God of Isaac, and I'm the God of Jacob. He is the God of living, not the dead." And Jesus is saying that God is the God of living and not of dead. Miss Jesus is, although taking care of our physical need, Jesus is satisfying our, giving us blessing or helping us to even fulfill our physical needs or joy and celebration, everything. But all the time, Jesus wants to draw our attention to his spirit. And when we go into the temple of Jesus Christ, we find there is statue of Jesus Christ on the cross, or some picture or something of Jesus Christ, at least his topic in the scripture that we hear. And all the followers of Jesus Christ, either it is Peter or Paul or many of them, they all speak beyond idolatry and wants to lead us beyond idolatry. And Jesus himself wants to lead us beyond idolatry. But in his own church, there is image of Jesus Christ. What is the meaning of this? And it is happening by the will of Jesus Christ himself. Why Jesus is there? And Jesus wants to explain to us that he is a living God. If he is also a dead person, then let him bury the dead. Let dead bury the dead. But here Jesus wants to explain to us that he is living, he is not dead. Although with all our emotions, we are waiting for second coming of Jesus Christ. But Jesus, whom we have seen on the cross, is living God. Because Jesus has taught living God. And if we are unable to feel Jesus as living God, and if we feel that Jesus is somebody who was born 2000 years ago and he died, then we are in idolatry and we are waiting for another coming of Jesus Christ. But here Jesus is living God, and Saint Paul has taught of resurrection of Jesus. And if Christ has not been raised, our preaching is useless and so is your faith. This is the message of Saint Paul, who is the person who has done the great work of God for Jesus Christ, in name of Jesus Christ. And he has taught only one thing, that is resurrection of Jesus Christ. So that whenever we go in the church and we see the idol of Jesus Christ, then we realize that Jesus is living God, he is not dead. And that's why Saint Paul has said, I don't know why Saint Paul has said, but we can get inspired by what Saint Paul has said one time, that if Christ has not been raised, our preaching is useless and so is your faith. Because then if we don't believe Jesus as a living God, then we are into idolatry. We are worshiping idols. But when we know that Jesus is living God, then we are into the real worship and we are understanding the God as God is. And that's the message, beautiful message of Jesus Christ. And that is how Jesus is trying to lead us to spirit. When we are worshiping Jesus Christ, we are born into spirit. And that is what I felt like sharing, and I feel inspired by your presence to share this, because Jesus is always trying to lead us to eternity. His only message is eternity all the time, and through love, because love is eternal. And so thank you so much for listening these words with so much of love. And there was one occasion when Jesus came to some place and where he was helping people or healing or giving them good news of divinity. Then there somebody made a hole on the roof, and where they made a paralyzed person fall down. And Jesus Christ, seeing their faith in Jesus, that they believe that Jesus is going to heal them, that they made such effort to come near Jesus. Jesus didn't feel offended. Jesus felt, wow, what a faith they have in Son of Man. And Jesus heals that person. And by healing, Jesus says, your sins are forgiven, something like that. Jesus said, I'm not too literal right now. And those people who were there, some of them were not into approval of this, that only God can forgive sin. How can Jesus forgive sin? And Jesus says that he has the authority, God has given him authority. And he says that what is easy to say somebody sin is forgiven, or it is that a person rise and walk. And Jesus told to that person, rise and walk. And that person started to rise, and they were all amazed. So here we find, in the name of Jesus Christ, we are worshiping to God's living spirit. When we take the name of Jesus, then we say Christ. And Saint Paul's way of speaking was Christ. He used to use Christ word always. So many times I have found that Paul is saying Christ Jesus, because Christ is eternal. and eternity of Jesus. Jesus is the Christ. Jesus is the living God, living Son of living God. And when we worship Jesus Christ, then we worship to living Spirit of Christ that is in all, by which God has that eternal Word, by which God has created everything. And the Word was with God, and the Word was God, by which everything is created. And through Jesus, we awaken that Christ inside us, inside everyone, and we enter into the world over here, not after our death, because Jesus is teaching life. Jesus says, I'm the life. So through Jesus, we worship, and it is a way. Jesus says, I'm the way. This means Jesus himself is leading us to the way of eternity over here in this world. When we worship Jesus, we worship to the eternal Spirit of God, by which we become ourselves reborn into Spirit, and we attain the eternal life over here, now, and here, because the scripture says today is the day of salvation. So with this prayer of Jesus Christ eternity, I thank you with all my love. And Jesus says, when we come together in name of God, then divinity awakens. We feel the name of God and the presence of God there, and God is living, is with us, is omnipresent, is listening to us. Jesus says that God knows us even before we were born or formed in the womb of our mom. And he says that may we close the door and seek our Father, because our Father knows even before we speak, because God is living, God is here and with us. So with this word of God and believing that God is listening to us and listens to our prayer and answers our prayer and loves us, with this love of Jesus, of living love of Jesus, where the touch of Jesus is as the grace or blessing in your life to fulfill all your dreams, all your wishes, all you want. And I thank you with this prayer for you, for us all, in love of Jesus. Thank you so much.